Hello. Hi. I'm Patricia McNeely. I'm an illumined Blu-ray twin flame from Chicago, Illinois. I hope you're doing well today. So today, what I want to talk to you about, today's actually the day of the new moon in March. And today's significant because new moons always mean, you know, going into that black, velvety, dark of the soil to plant the seeds for what you want. However, this new moon, this is leading into what's been planted actually several years ago. So today what I'm talking to you about is the Grand Cardinal Cross in April that is closing. Now, we had a Cardinal Cross in January that was in a different sign. However, this goes back to 2014, and this is the Grand Cross, which is all four corners of the universe. And for many people, it started in earnest in 2010 through 2014. Now, April of 2014 is when it peaked for a lot of people for all of their 5D through 9D experiences. So when I say experiences, I mean your parallel lives, your other planetary connections, you experiencing yourself as a higher ascended being in these places, and then the massive process of bringing it all in. From 2015 to 2016, where a lot of people were very impatient, and rightfully so, very impatient, because you were expecting things, having done all this stuff in April of 2014. I mean, it was bumpy. There were people having entire classes on just that Grand Cardinal Cross. And the Grand Cardinal Cross was, of course, Uranus, Jupiter, Mars, Pluto, forming a cross shape, but signifying bringing everything in. 2015 and 2016, especially finishing from October for all of the Blu-rays, for their 9D through 12D connections, experiences, the prototyping, transmuting, and elevating of those closest to their unions, especially for, you can't see this very well, but the rod and staff. So if you identify as a Blu-ray, you had a whole extra year here of stuff you were doing for your highest possible connections. If you don't know what I'm talking about, and this is very new to you, welcome. Welcome, and for some people it might feel like I'm preaching to the choir. That's not what this is about. This is about letting you know what's coming up here and ways to help you. So what is coming up here is, this is no longer the grand opening, this is the grand closing. This is the Omega tier Alpha. This is the Alpha and Omega and the Alpha again. So it is your ending, it is your beginning, and it is the ending of all the endings and the new beginnings for many people. Now, if you're just becoming aware of this, say in the past year, the past 6 months, the past few months, and you're saying, whoa, I didn't know what this is, I will bet you that if you look back, even back as far as your childhood, you'll come to realize in retrospect that you were being prepared for something pretty grand, very magnificent, and that it's coming to you. And you may feel as though you're at a crossroads. However, the crossroads already occurred in April of 2014. So there truly is no more crossroad. You are at another level and you're going. Now, there are people who have completely turned their back on this, and yet even they may find that they are very pleasantly surprised by the universe, because there's a lot that's been done to make this happen. Now, the kicker to this being that not everyone is coming together this year. However, certain unions that are absolutely critical, and people who have met their twin in at least the past several lives, going to happen. And you're going to keep getting smushed together until you get it right. Now, that being said, a lot of what people are going through, there's quite a bit of sadness. There are still departures. There's not only people dying, you are leaving people behind. You're leaving entire worlds and civilizations behind. There's sadness. There's leaving. You're releasing the pain of diasporas, famines, also slavery, and all the forgotten children. Children who've been kidnapped, pressed into, you know, things, doing things that they don't want to do. And this is from other lives as well. These are from past lives. These are all the forgotten childhoods, the deprived childhoods, the neglected childhoods. There are people acting and behaving very juvenile because they've had what is quite literally a stunted emotional growth. Now, you're not here for your intelligence anymore. You're here for the emotional growth and well-being, along with all of the other subtle body parts of yourself, which I've talked about throughout all my videos, going right back, you know, 3 years ago when I started. The children are a part of your unions. They're going to need your help. So if your kid is exhibiting what you might sense as ascension symptoms, but that are slightly different than what you went through, and yet they're complaining. They have stomach aches. They have headaches. They're having low energy. They're bearing up little inflammations that you're sensing somehow are not just a common cold or just a normal thing. Or they are complaining about aches and pains and pokes on their body. Pay attention to them. Give them the care that they need. If you don't know what to do, I'm here to help with that. And I have a lot of things to do about it. The April activations and this very watery energy, some of you are going to feel as though you're in a body of water. Very wavy, very fluid, and yet sometimes leaving you feel discombobulated, disoriented, slightly with a sense of vertigo around you. And if this is very new to you, you may find that you're having other aches and pains on parts of your body that are trying to get out of old and ancient timelines. The window is closing in April. So for those of you who have worried, what if my twin keeps drinking? What if my twin keeps carousing? What if my twin keeps sleeping with men, women, anybody? What if my twin engages and starts a family with someone? Well, the window's closing on it. The window is closing on all the old ways. What do you do to help your twin from overriding this? There are things that you can do. Yes, of course. You don't just sit by and just say, well, I'm going to give up the ghost and you know what? I wish them a wonderful life. No, you want to know why? I'm going to tell you why right now. Because they will affect your energies. They will affect how you feel. And increasingly, there are no more separations between you two. Now, that started back as far as October of 2010. October of 2013, now this is sort of a nice little tie-in here. If any of you remember the Disney movie Frozen, and Frozen had the song in it, Let It Go, okay? That movie kind of came out in November of 2013 and carried us into this April energy, starting up the whole, you had people singing it all over the place. You know, just singing it and singing it. You know, I can't sing it. I don't own the license. But you know the one I'm talking about. Let it go. Okay. You started letting go of everything, and it was bumpy, and it shook the foundation, and it turned you upside down, and it shook you some more, and it shook everything out of you. It did, didn't it? Yeah, I remember that part. I did a video on it. Grand Cardinal Cross of April 2014. Check it out on my channel because you will find out what that entailed. Now, some of you might feel like you skimmed over it, but guess what? Boom. 2015-2016 happened, and it was on, pedal to the metal, and there was a lot of intensity. Well, guess what? This is going to be intense. You better learn how to hold steady for your twin, because the intensity is on for them now. Whatever you may have experienced previously, it's on. They've got this much time and this much to do and pulling up the rear. Now, if you cannot hold on, then I can't really say what's going to happen, but I will say this. The solution is not to dive back into a soulmate, not to stick other people's energies into you. And you know what I'm talking about by now. Some of you are saying, getting to the point where you're saying, am I crazy? I've been hanging on to this thing. I don't know what I'm hanging on for. I'm telling you what you're hanging on for, quite in earnest here. Please hang on. Please wait. Because the very thing that you've wished for, you're pulling it all in. Now, some of you may remember that I did this. I did this in March of 2016. I showed you all of the cross energy and what it signified. Air, etheric, water, earth, fire, the passion, the love, bringing it all into the love. What everything is, where it was going. All of the passion held by Mars, all of the impulsive stuff. So let's say, for example, a la Frozen, that you've been perceived as an ice princess or something like this. Except you aren't. You've been hurt so much by love, they've had to keep your heart icy. Except here comes your twin, and here comes the fire necessary to thaw out your frozen heart. Okay? And you're all actually giving up this persona of being the ice princess. It's other people's ideas of what you are. And that's another thing. A lot of mental beliefs are going. What are beliefs? Well, people believe that the earth is flat. It's round. There was a belief at one time that somehow people did not need to wash their hands to go in and help deliver a baby. That this was actually considered outlandish until it was proven that doctors working in a morgue who had not washed their hands went and delivered a baby and touched that baby after touching dead flesh. And 9 times out of 10, the babies died until someone was able to debunk this belief. There are beliefs that true love, the scale of which some of you have experienced, many of you, somehow doesn't exist. And yet it does. And yet you're saying to yourself, yeah, but it can't exist here. That is why this has taken so long to get so many people elevated to the level where it can exist and you can hold it and you can hold the harmonics of your union. That's why, yes, it has taken linear time. And yes, some people cannot wait. Some people feel the peer pressure. Some people are being pressed into situations they don't want. Some people are being arranged into marriages or trying to get themselves pregnant because they can feel their clock running out. What kind of children are going to grow up with karmic parents? They're going to have karmic experiences. And yet, the couples who are coming together this summer will be having the conceptions for their brand new love children. Now, there are some people I've spoken to who, yes, are twin flames and, yes, have gotten pregnant and made their babies. And time will tell us how new these children are. But some things that they aren't going to experience, you know, some of the aspects of those forgotten childhoods, the neglect, the deprivation, the nutritional deprivation, healthcare deprivations, educational deprivations. And, you know, this is all a balancing. This is very delicate. It's very subtle. This is involving your subtle bodies. And the other thing is that the long-awaited Blu-ray unions will occur. So I'm going to say something right now. If you're a Blu-ray, if you're actually a rod and staff union and you know yourself to be, thank you. Thank you for doing what you came here to do. Because you've been transmuting stuff. You've been transmuting large bundle stuff. You've been doing grid work. You've been creating templates. It's going to be your time. Now, if you identify as an illumined golden or blue golden seraphim, and you are knowing you have connections to the new earth, but you haven't done your grid work. And what is the grid work? The grid work is going to some of these spots and removing your energies from them. You know, removing your airy energies, removing the fire, removing your earthy energies, your watery aspects. Water is love and emotion. Fire is the passion. The earth is the physical form, and the air and the etheric is your angelic light body. All of it goes together, and all of it is being put together and merged together. And yes, the physical union with your true other half, who has the exact matching vibration to you in the entire universe, is critical. This is a critical point. So we're coming up to the time frame where it's critical now. Yes, and yes, you have to come together. Don't worry, if you miss this one, you can go next year, or the next year, or the next year. But nothing is going to stop you coming together with your twin flame. Sometimes just people's scary heads. But those are genuine fears. Those fears are held in the root, and the head, and the eyes. And there it is. So, now of course, many of you received your owner's manual for twin flames version 2010, didn't you? Didn't you get this? You didn't get one of these when you were a child? Nobody gave you one? Wait a minute. Nobody handed you one of these and told you all about meeting your twin flame and how, you know, things in your life would change and you'd go through transformations? They really didn't? They didn't tell you how you'd become as melty as cheese with each other? No? They didn't? Okay. That's just a little teeny joke there. But I do have things that will help you with this. I have my webinar called New Lives and New Timelines, where I talk in detail in there about the new masculine, what he is, what he isn't. And no, the new masculine is not an emasculated version. It's very masculine, very sexy, but without some of the macho, maybe more old school connotations. And yet, it's masculine with the swag without the swagger. Okay, the grid work. Also, I talk a lot in there about your new chakra connection. So if you've been having pains in the right hip, the sciatic nerve, down the leg, or from the lower body, check out this webinar, because I have things in there for you to do that will support you. And yes, I'm a teacher of the new light body. This is being done through the body. You don't bring in the four corners of the universe to yourself without using your light body to do so. You're not doing it with your human head. And yet, this part here that helps you function here will frequently say to you, this is outlandish, this is crazy, this is wild, this is otherworldly. I don't know if we can believe this. Is this really our life? Is this my life? And yes, this is your life. This is your life in transition. This is your life in transformation, and this is your life as you come together. And some of you are together. There are people together that are still doing these aspects of bringing things in, and as they do, they clear And they purge, they clear, they bring in. They purge, they clear, they bring in. Wash, rinse, repeat. Kind of like the instructions on a bottle of shampoo. Now, the other one that I have is the Divine Lover's Cosmic Body. These are for cosmic level opening of your channels, including your chakras. You have several subtle bodies. You have several energetic fields. It's all love because that's what you're made from. One of the key differences between me and maybe the way other people will teach is I'm very twin flame specific. There's two of you. There's two. I'm able to read through the heart energies about two of you. If I could read your mind, love, what a tale my thoughts would tell. Well, I don't read the mind. I'm reading the heart. I read the subtle bodies. I can tell you on your body what, you know, what's going on and what happens. Now, this is the result of doing years of reconnective body work where I actually physically have people on my massage table and I'm working on them. And I'm opening their chakras and I'm clearing things and I'm reconnecting them. That is something that I'm able to do now at the cosmic level. So I do, not only do I do private sessions, one-on-one sessions, I do follow up with people. If you need a follow up, if you need to get back on track, you know, and sometimes I'm like, you know, if you're driving on the road and your car goes off the road, yeah, you call me and I help you get back on the road here. If you are just needing someone to talk to that knows this, yes, I do that as well. Also, I have my live group webinars that I do where I guide you through moving your energies so that you can feel, so that you know it, so that you're creating your own activations, so that you're feeling. Okay, that has been, I would say, the number one thing with people, and I've seen this happen where, you know, what people really want is to be in love. They want to touch, they want to know when is the merge happening, or did we merge, or something like that. And yet, the preparation that goes in for that is important, it's significant, and yet it is a one-time only thing. Once you prepare yourself for different levels of merged, you're in. This is how you're going to get through these things. This is how you're going to heal. This is how you do by being who you are. And many of you, if you're a Seraphim, what's coming up for you is going to be your cosmic heart merge. I also talk in here in this new lives, new timelines about the back of the heart, the back of the heart chakra, and the preparation that goes in for your cosmic heart merge. Now, if you're a Blu-ray, you probably already experienced that. I experienced that a couple years ago, and, you know, meanwhile have been writing things about it. The other thing I'm starting is in April, I'm starting a live class. I have a curriculum put together. It's a two-day workshop. The times are announced on my website. So far, I'm starting it for 1 week on April 22nd, 23rd. So, you know, this might be an option for you. This might be an option for you. Check my website. I will have the links below in the description if you're interested in this one. Now, if you have it, dig it out, review it again, because it's going to be very helpful for this time frame going into April. Now, I will say some other things here. For the people that are the Blu-rays, or if you feel that you're a Blu-ray, you're going to know, because you're going to be doing something significant. And, you know, more than likely, you or your other, that is a misconception, is that, you know, the other, frequently referred to as the man, and it's not just men, but men get a sort of a bum's rush on this. They're the ones doing these higher aspects. They're the ones bringing it to their twin. If you're out messing with another soulmate, you're not really staying still to receive what rightfully belongs to you. And this is a time for everything had to have come back to the rightful owners. Also, you may have heard me talk about these professional headings, okay? And some of the very last ones where people have had ill effects. Politics, religion, the music, the arts, medical, healing, science, technology. So the science and technology people are very serious and Uranus energied, Pluto. Politics, very serious. Religion, very serious, and Pleiades. That's where you'll have two different consciousnesses. That's where you'll have what has become Eastern and Western style religions and so forth. You're trying to meld that together. So if you, for example, you have someone who is from India and you have someone who is from Italy and there's two different religious backgrounds that they're brought up in, and how do you meld this together? You're not going to meld it together with your head. You're not going to say, you know, well, gosh, we'll do both. You may enjoy traditions from that. And that's what this energy is about, too, as we go into April. New relationships. It's all about relationships. How do you relate from within your union to that thing? So let's say you enjoy a tradition that you grew up with. And you say, well, I always want to have a Christmas tree. Or I always want to do the Festival of Lights. Rituals or, you know, I like parts of that. It makes me feel good. It touches my heart. Then by all means, do it. But what you're going to get rid of are the negative aspects of it. You're going to get rid of the demands upon you about it, or the commands, or the obligations. You will be left with the pure joy of what aspect it is that you love. And that's the new relationship. New relationships with family. One-on-one relationships with bosses, with the police, with the government, with your money, with your bank. All about new relationships, or making the relationships new in some way. If you don't know what to do about it, new lives. That's where I start to talk about it. New lives and new timelines. So some of the other things, one of the things that I left out of here, diasporas, famines, religious persecution. People don't want to hear it. And yet they are having body memories come out of what? Maybe being burnt. Maybe being hung. You know, and all you can do is feel things. That's been a very terrible thing that has happened to many people. Or religious conversion. What would you do with people that are enslaved and they're brought to another country and you beat their old religion out of them and you beat the new one into them? When is that going to pop out? Well, guess what? It's popping out with this Venus retrograde. Now, Venus's energy starts to go direct mid-April. That's going to be the culmination of this. The Jupiter retrograde goes until June before it starts to. So this is all of the wishes and the wants and the desires and the making it better, the improvements, the rewritings, the children, anything. That's why you're leaking out the sadness now. That's why you're crying. That's why it's simply leaking out. You can have a memory just wash over your body or just well up from inside. And you say, where did this come from? Well, guess what? It came from the Pleiades and it came from Venus and it came from Antares and Lyra and, you know, any other places that you've ever been on, Nibiru, Uranus, you name it. Whatever planetary connections you may feel or be aware of, and some a lot that you maybe not be aware of. So if, like I say, just as a little joke, you don't have your twin flame owner manual, because none of us really do. None of us were handed one. And yet, you have met your true love and you've seen them, or you've dreamt them and you've been having wonderful experiences up here. Here's the twin up here and you feel like you're down here and, you know, who should I be with? You're waiting for this person, okay? You're waiting for the person to be fully integrated and together. And you give your own self a chance. This entire year has been all of the second and third and fourth and fifth and umpteen chances at infinitum. You will have time and again to do it right, to rewrite the script until you get it back into the love connection. Stop, because I really love you. Okay, I stopped. I listened to you. You're actually listening? That's another thing with this. We haven't been able to hear each other, see each other, feel each other. The ears, the eyes, pay attention, because I'm going to have that information coming up in another webinar for you. So if, like this couple, you really, 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 really know in your heart, or even if you don't know it 100%, but you're pretty sure that you're here to be in love with your true love, it's the only thing you felt since the time of a child. And a lot of you do. I know people whose favorite house when they were a child was to play house. I mean, their favorite game as a child was to play house. Or they always had to be the dad. Or they always had to, you know, somehow be the mom or something like that. They knew. Something in them knew. They're not just here to play house. They're here to make their house together. They're here to make their house. So your seventh house is the house of all of that. House, relationships, family. You know, it's going to be your financial security, your finances, everything that you're getting out of old survival mode and into the new. New lives, new timelines. Check it out. It's at the link below. Let me know if you would like to talk or meet with me. I am here to help. And as always, please have a wonderful week. I hope that everything goes well for you. Please don't be afraid, because the universe has some delightful surprises for people who are coming into their full physical union. Physical unions, yes, physical union, physical, the physical one. Yes, I said it, physical union. Okay, take care, have a great week. Bye now.